Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Confronts Theater. This is our 25th rendition of Saturday Night Live. I don't think it's the silver anniversary of Valentine's Day particularly, but of all the Saturday Night Live. And it's really been very popular, and I think everybody in the country has seen Saturday Night Live, and that's pretty much the format. Now, to have a great show, it's live theater, and so we really encourage audience participation. So laugh, boo, holler, everything. Just don't throw anything, we'll be fine. If you have a cell phone, please turn it off at this time. And our restroom is right over here. It's both men and women, and then at intermission, we'll open up this side for the females. We'll put the males on this side. Or if you want something else, you can go down to down to Sharp's, and let's go in there too. So enjoy the show. I think you'll really love it. And Covenant Brothers presents Saturday Night Live.
Talk about missing something, huh? But anyway, I do stay busy indeed.
Good evening. Can I get you two some drinks?
Oh, I'll have them in.
And for you, sir?
Give me a double shibboleth on the rocks for the twist, please.
Manhattan and a double shibboleth on the rocks, sir. I'll have those out of me.
Thank you. Would you please excuse me, Claire?
No, absolutely.
I must use the restroom.
Rebecca?
Hi. Oh my gosh, it is going so great. I really think I met the perfect guy. Oh, he is so handsome and so well-educated. I've been talking to him for 20 minutes, and I have not found one flaw with him. Not one.
You know, I'm glad I've had this pleasure of meeting you tonight, Claire. You look very lovely.
Oh, you're quite lovely yourself, Tyrell. I mean, you're very handsome. I mean, you know what I mean.
Absolutely.
Hey, Manhattan for a lady. And a double shibboleth on the rocks with a twist.
Thank you, sir.
May I get you anything else at this time?
Well, I think that'll be about all, son. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
So, what should we drink to?
Let's see. Prosperity, happiness, a long-lasting friendship may be very favorable to both of us.
Getting me all flustered, Tyrell.
Oh, to you, Clarice.
Good?
Very good. Now, tell me, where were we?
We were just discussing your career.
Not enough about me, Claire. Let's talk about you. Tell me, what do you do?
Well, I'm a nurse practitioner. I've been doing that for the past 7 years. Sometimes it's a little straining. But are you okay?
Ah, never felt better. What's
with the noises?
Excuse me?
The noises when you were. Never mind, it's probably just me.
Okay. So, your work is stressful and all that.
It is.
Yeah.
Yes,
I do too.
I enjoy helping people. I'm really helping people.
I like helping people too, Claire. You know, I feel we're put on this earth for one reason, to help each other. At least that's how I feel.
Here's your appetizer, sir. Clams and cream sauce.
Oh, yes, very well. Thank you. And here, take the girlfriend out for something special.
Thank you, sir.
No problem. So, are you an oyster type of lady, Claire?
I've never had one.
Here, try one. They're delicious.
So, how do you...
Well, basically, you put it to your mouth, and you suck.
You just suck?
Yes. Trust me, the noise gets a little bothersome at sometimes, but the pleasure of the taste overrides your taste buds. Trust me.
Okay. These are really good.
Mm-hmm. And like I said, the noise doesn't even compare to the sensation on the back of your tongue, does it?
No, not at all.
Like I said, noise doesn't even compare. Yep, noise doesn't even compare.
Tyrell, it's starting to get a little,
A little what, Claire?
Tyrell, I'm sorry, you seem so perfect.
I know, keep going.
But, I can't imagine, like...
Can't imagine what, Claire?
I can't imagine being around these noises you make when you drink and eat for more than a day, let alone the next 10 minutes.
I see. I wasn't always like this, Claire. When I was a kid, I got attacked by a basset hound. And he ripped out my tongue. My father believed in the eye for an eye conviction. Or so he says. So he hunted down that dog, ripped out its thing's tongue, that's what I meant to say, and he surgically implanted it in my mouth. It's ruined my life, ruined relationships, it's ruined everything. So if you want to stand up and go, just go.
No, Tyrell, I'm sorry, I would never guess.
It's okay. Really, it is. It's okay.
No, I shouldn't judge. I'm gonna stay.
You know, Claire, you're the first girl that's ever stayed. The first. Here's to you.
Oh, oh, oh!
Yeah, I can't do this.
Internet Explorer, Pornhub.com. I have nothing else. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is Comedy Night 25, starring, and hopefully I don't forget someone, Jim Cameron.
Let me introduce myself. I am Charles Balfour Stillwater.
as better known as Chuck Stillwater. I am the boss of a gang of outlaws in north central Wyoming at the Arrowwood Ranch. This is in the late 1870s, 1879 to be exact. This is the first episode which we will be showing. It centers around Peacock Sawmill. It's a very exciting story. We'll see what happens in the first episode. And I will step aside and let the show begin.
Get back to you know my problem is? I'm just too soft hearted for my own good.
Luigi. up and wash your face and get ready for dinner.
Oh, okay, Father.
You're gonna remember our anniversary dinner tonight, the Vincenta.
No, I have business.
What kind of a business?
Zelda Gold Edition. What business?
Let's get upstairs, wash up for dinner.
Oh, take my money and go!
Fabrizio and I just took care of Mr. Smith, who works down at the meatpacking plant.
Turns out he doesn't pay his debts.
So what did you do with him?
Fabrizio. I made him an offer that he couldn't refuse, but he refused the offer, so I blew his effing head off.
Dinner was over!
an offer that I can't refuse.
Come on, Doc!
Okay, now where was I? Yes, we're going to need to have your help with this smuggling in the shipment of angel hair pasta.
Don't you mean angel dust?
No, that's the other shipment.
Oh, very good, Don.
Hey, why can't I go on any drug raids with you guys, huh?
You were much too young, Fabio.
Wait, I'm older than Fabrizio.
Latin dog years.
Fabio, you must learn the way of the mafia before you can join us.
It's many, many drugs, then many, many years.
All right, then. I want to go!
Didn't have to crush his dreams like that.
Oh.
Of murdering